What's up, YouTube? It's always from Jacob. Fuck apparel. What's up, Jacob? It's fuck you.
Ah. You're fucking OG.
What's up, YouTube? It's Jacob from Always Fresh Apparel, and today, that felt good. So, hey, guys. Yeah. Fuck. Sorry. Damn. Yeah. Okay. Try not to cuss. Man, so on the real, I'm here. This is real. I'm back and forth. Talking to you guys, the last few days I just really felt like making a video, so I tweeted a little something and I said, "My fuck around and make a video," and you know that's what happened. And it's not that I'm back, but you know I might sprinkle this meme is dead. I might sprinkle you know some love on your guys' feeds, maybe once every few months. You never know. Just kind of let you know that I'm still alive. I still got some heat. I still buy clothes, not as often as I used to. That's another reason I stopped. Because, you know, as I grow older, you know, I'm 25 now. I got car insurance and stuff like that. You know, I can't be dropping. Well, yeah, you're going to see some of the stuff in here. It's going to be a little bit. But this is 2 years of stuff, all right? So that's fucking awesome. Thank you, iPhone. I just recorded about 10 minutes and realized that it wasn't recording. So, all right, y'all, we're going to get into the tease. So I got tees, jackets, pants, and shoes. I'm gonna do about 5 of each. So here we go. This one is a Rick Owens level short t-shirt. So I copped this one off the Essence sale. It was like $80. So don't, this is gonna feel good to say. Don't tell me you can't find some steals. Okay, bam. Okay, here we go. Damn, that was awesome. Okay, I like this one because usually level t-shirts are super, super long, but I got the short version so it sits perfectly. It hits like right at my waist. Don't even really have to tuck it in. Wear it with some skinny jeans or some Rick trousers, some Ramones, whatever you want to do. The reason I like this one is because it's got a nice kind of tight neck and it still fits a little bit slim on my body, which is really nice. You know, I have a ton of oversized shirts, so it's really nice to get a slim shirt in the wardrobe. So yeah, $80, super easy. Okay, cool. All right, you guys, next up is this 1994 Pink Floyd t-shirt. I got it from a friend, Cole, who kind of sells his vintage clothes in Macus. That little area of the store is gonna be called something else. So if you guys wanna go check out his collection, you can buy some vintage stuff. This one I really love because of the hand to it. It's super soft and super worn in, you know. Some dude washed this, you know, 200 times. The graphic is really nice. I like that it's orange. I don't have any that is like a nice orange. And then here's the back, North American Tour 1994. So, and if you really want to question my Pink Floyd game, you can. They're one of my favorite bands of all time. Even before I was doing YouTube, my dad put me onto them. I love this band so much that I'm gonna get some of their lyrics tatted in the near future. I have a few phrases picked out. I'm gonna do Wish You Were Here, one of my favorite songs. Got it. If you know those memes where it's like if someone put a gun to your head and you had to sing an entire song without messing up and you got to live, if you've never seen that, I'm sorry, I would pick Wish You Were Here. So I'm gonna get that from my grandparents. Unfortunately, in the time that I made all these videos, and I haven't been making videos, all my grandparents have passed away. Not to take a dark turn or anything, but I'm gonna get that to remember them. So, Pink Floyd. Okay, moving on to the next one. Okay, next one is this 1992, the year I was born, that's why I love it so much, Pearl Jam Choices t-shirt. This one is awesome. I got this one off eBay. The best part is the back. It says 9 out of 10 kids prefer crayons to guns. Fucking sick. But I just got it in the day before I was going to go to California to go to Disneyland, because that's where my girl wanted to go for her birthday, which was, if you've ever been to Disneyland and when you're like 25 or an adult, go. That shit's fun again. I remember when I was like 12, but when you're 25, it's just as fun. And I was going to bring this shirt. But then I said, yeah, maybe I shouldn't wear this to Disneyland. So I actually haven't worn it yet. Yeah, I'm hyped on it. So here you guys go. Eddie Vedder, Pearl Jam, 1992, eBay. Okay, cool. Next up, if you follow me on Instagram, you know I've been rocking this tee a lot lately. Not this tee, this button up a lot lately. This is from Double Rainbow. It's a brand actually out of Hawaii. They're super sick. So it's like a tastefully done Hawaiian print shirt. Because Hawaiian print shirts, like, you know, they can get real grandpa and real, you know, it won't really look tastefully done real fast. But this brand, you know, they try to do that for sure. It's made out of 100% rayon, so, you know, it's real flowy. The cut is really nice. It's like a little bit oversized, a little bit longer. So I just tuck it to get a nice kind of short effect. I wear this with, like, skinny black jeans and like my Dior boots, and it kind of gives off like a Saint Laurent vibe if you really want to. And then like I like it because you can also go to dinner afterwards, and then you know you're still wearing a button-up shirt, and it doesn't look like you got it from your grandpa. You know, their collection is actually, they basically took the inspiration from that but made it a little bit modern. So Double Rainbow, I'll link it in the description. We have some more at Macus left. I think we have one or two left. We have a few other colors too. So here you guys go. Real nice. Look at that. Real flowy. And I can talk about these expensive t-shirts all day, but at the end of the day, what I really wear, I mean, I do wear these, but sorry. What I really wear almost every single day is goddamn, is Gildan t-shirts, okay? This one's a Gildan one. This one's a Gildan one. I'm gonna try to show y'all that you can still get away with the $3 t-shirt swag. Shout out Chris Fennimore. Okay, anyways, this is my Gildan t-shirt. My favorite one is the, is it the ultra? It's the heavy cottons. My favorite ones are the heavy cottons. They have heavy cotton and ultra cotton. So I will link it down below. I got a bunch of colors. This is a large, so it fits a little slim, but still has a little bit of room right here. This one's an XL. I just wanna wear a big one when I'm in the house. I love this, man. Like, I wear this tucked in again to like some baggy trousers or like, you know, some straight leg pants with boots. I wore this in my one of my last Instagram pictures that did, Crimer did my snake, and I wore it tucked in, and everyone was like, oh my God, what tee is that? They like DM me, and I was like, I didn't want to tell them that it was a $3 Gildan t-shirt I got on Amazon. So, but that's really what it is. So here you guys go. I'll link it. It's fire. Let's get onto the pants now. Okay. I'm gonna do this. All right, you guys. God, I wish these would stand on their own. Next up for the pants is this pair of Balenciaga red stripe straight leg jeans. I absolutely love these, man. And yeah, you know, I paid about retail. I actually paid under retail from a guy. And it was a purchase I was like, God, I've been trying to spend less and less money, you know, ever since I stopped YouTube. But this was something that I just had to get. The reason that it drew me to them is that they are like a straight leg. So it's not going to be like a super skinny pant. And it does have like a higher rise. So this is like a super, super high rise. You can wear it really, really high on your waist, which is like, it's super hard for me to find jeans that have like a high rise. All of like jeans have super low rises, and I can't stand it. I like to wear myself higher because visually it makes me look taller when I tuck my shirts in. It's just like a visual proportions thing. I had, you know, these run super long. If you've never, Sange did a video on these. They run super long, so you have to get them hemmed. So I got them hemmed to sit right at my sneakers. So when I wear like Air Force Ones with them, they sit like right here. But then what I do when I wanna wear them with boots is I honestly just fold them in. I just fold them in on themselves like this so that I can wear them with boots, because I'm super fucking indecisive and I don't wanna commit to hemming my jeans that short when maybe one day I wanna wear them with sneakers. So I just fold them in on themselves. I guess I could fold them on the outside. Anyways, yeah. Shout out Luke Vicious for this chain. Shout out, I bought this belt, but shout out Alix, one of my favorite brands. Yeah, this is one of my favorite pair of jeans. Here you guys go. Let's get on to the next pair. Bam, next up is a pair of these Dries Van Noten patchwork jeans. Again, with the Balenciaga, these are more of like a straight leg denim. So, and of course, I'm a short guy. Every single pant runs about a 34 inseam. So I gotta roll these ones. I'm not sure if I wanna crop them yet, or if I wanna cut them, or if I really wanna professionally hem them. But right now I'm just rolling them. And these do, again, have like a, God, my arm is getting so tight. These have a nice rise too. So I can wear these a little bit higher up. So anytime I find a jean like that, I cop it, because it's really hard to come across. This isn't even real patchwork. This is actually just a print. So the whole inside of the denim just is like this, this like kind of off-white color. So it really, I mean, when you really look at it, it looks like real patchwork. Added a chain, have my red belt, Dries Van Noten. I got a size 34. They didn't have a 32, so I had to go up a size. So that's why I got to belt it. But again, this with a white t-shirt and my black Dior boots. I even wore them with that Pink Floyd tee and my white Air Force yesterday. Super versatile. You can like dress it up with some boots or dress it down with some sneakers. When you can find a pant that can be worn in multiple ways, you gotta cop it. So these were originally $700. I got them for $250. So again, do not tell me you cannot find steals. Bam, another pair of jeans, and another pair of high-rise jeans. Like I said, if I find them, I buy them, okay? This one is from Purple, a brand we carry in the store. It is the private label denim from Roden Gray up in Canada. So it's their own house line of denim. The guys over there were super grateful enough to send me a pair of these. I really appreciate it, guys. They have become one of my most worn pairs of jeans. I wore these jeans with my Dior boots and this that Gildan tee I showed off in that picture with Crimer and my tattoo guy, and everyone loved these jeans. So I'm showing you, they are right here. This is the style number 2. This is the dropped fit. So dropped fit meaning the rise is dropped, meaning it's gonna be a longer rise, meaning I can wear them a little bit higher. Still super skinny through the leg. Of course, like I said, every pant is way too long on me. So for these ones, I cut them, folded them up once, and then just put these safety pins in there so that the stitch doesn't come unraveled. I don't do this for aesthetic, I do it for practicality. I do it so my shit doesn't rip apart. Super faded, washed black jean all throughout. Kind of has some like zigzag stitching and some rips and some paint splatters all over. This is one of my favorite pair of jeans. Love them with the black leather patch on the back. We have like a ton of purple jeans at Macus. It's like a brand we're pushing really hard for the next few years. So it's like our main denim brand right now. So I will link their collection on our site right now. Okay, my next pant is, do not let hypebeasts or people that you don't respect that wear a brand influence your decisions on that brand. That's all I'm saying. So these are Off-White pants. I've never had Off-White pants in my life. I love Virgil. And I met him in Paris. He's a super, super nice guy. Like, and I think what he does is incredible. We all know that it's kind of become this like, you know, Instagram brand, like hype brand, whatever. But I'm not gonna let that stop me from buying a pant I really like because it's Off-White. I mean, because, yeah, so, okay. This one is the wash track pant. We still have one pair left at Macus. It is a like super pretty baggy, yeah, super baggy trouser. Again, you can see the little rolls up right there because every pant is too long on me, so I gotta roll these up. Probably should just get them hemmed. I'll go take a look at Taylor. Super dope drawstrings with the, right here it says, what does it say? Metal tip, Off-White. It literally says metal tip, Off-White on the drawstring. This is main label, 2013, oh, it says 2013. This was spring, is this fall winter? Yeah, this is fall winter 17. It's got the little angel right there, and it has this like velour side strip going down the seam. So that's why it's a track pant. It's got one back pocket for your wallet, and it's like this super, super soft, washed, like broken in material. So I love these. I mainly wear these with sneakers. I don't think I could pull these off with boots or anything, but these are great. Highly recommend them. We have one pair left, so shop them now. I wore these with my second layer button up and some Air Force Ones, and people loved it. So yeah, man, you can pull this stuff off in a bunch of different ways. I wear a white tee tucked in too. So that's why I say, if you find a pant or a shirt that you can wear a ton of different ways, you should go for it. So yeah, man, here you go. Okay, and I might be talking about all these expensive pants, which all those pants were very expensive, but at the end of the day, man, at the end of the day, I always come back to my Who Is Jakov, Jacob Keller collab shorts. Guys, I have worn these so many times. I know there's not really any pictures of me, but man, I get people coming into the shop wearing them, and I'm like, oh, thanks, man. That like means a lot. Thank you. And they're like, dude, I have tried to buy another pair of shorts because I wear these so much to try to get me to not wear them so much, and I can't. There's like nothing that I can to buy that matches this. And I was like, you hit it right on the nose. That's what me and Jacob did. Like, we literally couldn't wear any. There was no shorts we could wear, so we made the best version of a short we could do. They sit nice and, you know, right above the knee. They're a little bit wide. They have a nice drop, so you can, you know, your balls can breathe. Josh and I wore these every day in Disneyland, and my dad has a pair. He wears them every day. Cole has a pair. He wears them all the time when it gets hot. Like, it's super awesome to see that. It's a year later, it's like 13 months later, and people are still wearing this short. So that's, I'm not even a designer, but as someone that designed this, that's probably one of the best feelings ever. You're, you know, someone doesn't go and sell them on Grail or take them to Buffalo, like they're still wearing it 13 months later. So I think we still have some more on the site. I just texted Jacob about it. I actually texted him asking if I could get another pair just when these blow out or something, like a few years down the line. So yeah, man, I love them. I'll put the link down there. Please go shop them. I appreciate it. Thanks. Okay, so now I'm gonna do jackets last. Now we're gonna get into the shoes. Okay, stuff I've been wearing a lot lately. As you know, Dior combat boots from 07, the Navigator boots. These are crazy. I've had these since 2014. 2015, 2014? So it's been like 2 or 3 years. And look at them, they're holding up. I wear them almost every day. I might want to go get the leather maybe shined up a little bit. It's a little dull right now. And just maybe get some of this painted black again. But I mean, I am going to have to find an alternative eventually because these will give out in some, you know, in a few years, and I need something that can match it, which I haven't found anything yet. So, you know, these go for, that is a big chunk of crap right there. These go for about $1,200 on Grailed. I paid $400 like years ago before that, you know, people were really onto them, which was, I'm glad I fucking did that. Thank you, Jacob Hetzer. Yeah, my most worn pair of boots, absolutely, by far. I know like Saint Laurent has some options, but nothing is like as buttery as this leather. So that leads into my next pair. My next pair is these Andemula Meisters, which I've been wearing a ton too. These are awesome. I got these off of Essence's sale like a year and a half, 2 years ago too, because I wore those so much. I was like, man, I need another pair so that I don't wear those so much, but I still wear those so much. So Dior, you're not gonna be watching this, but Dior. Anyways, these Andemula Meisters are super sick. They have like a flat sole, whereas the Dior's, they have like that little wedge right there, as you can tell. These ones are just straight flat, and they have a bunch of leaves on them. So like a super flat sole, kind of the same silhouette coming up. About, these are a little bit shorter, but kind of the similar height. And then what happens is the tongue comes up super high and then folds over, and then there's a buckle right here that you can lock it in. So I was like contemplating cutting this tongue off, but then I realized like that's what makes this boot different than my Dior's. Why would I want to make it the same? So these are fucking rad. I got them for like $300. So Andemula Meister. Okay. Next up, a pair I've been wearing just, I mean, I know they don't look too beat, but a pair of just Air Force Ones, man. I'm a size 8 in these. I don't know, I got a small foot. I threw in my own insoles. A dude that his parents own Ortholite. Shout out you, Nick. He came in and brought us all Macus Ortholite insoles that he printed in the factory, but I wore these so much that the Macus is rubbed out, unfortunately. But I love these things, man. Because of the insole now, I can wear them all day and nothing hurts. So these go with everything. I honestly wear these with every pair of pants that I just showed off. So that's why I like these, super versatile. Okay. Next up, we have a collaboration I am super fond of. If you follow me on Instagram, you know. We have the Alix Vans. Matthew Williams is like one of my inspirations. We've met a few times. He's fucking awesome. I'm not wearing it. He gave me a super dope necklace. That's an Alix Fragment necklace. I really appreciate it, dude. You fucking rock. These are the Spring Summer 17 ones. These are the, they're not the old schools because they're like a different model. You know, this lace comes out farther than a normal old school. But I love them. They have like the little Alix tab as always that they do on everything. This is the white colorway. I have the black colorway with the pink laces. I love these ones too. These are replacing as my everyday old schools. So this is spring summer 17, 8.5. And then I got the fall winter 17, which is these bad boys right here. This is the skate high, but it's technically not the skate high. It's like the OG 40, it's something else, because it actually has a little bit more of some white rubber right here. We still have some of these at Macus if you guys want to shop them. You know, it is still like a skate high silhouette, but they did, you know, the suede and the cream, and then they included these super sick black and silver laces that I threw in there. You also have the Alix tab right there. So, hyped on these, love them. Wore them with the Dries Van Noten pants and got a lot of compliments. So, those are my shoes I've been rocking. Honestly, that's kind of all it's been. I wear boots like 4 days a week, probably Air Forces the rest of the two, and then Vans like one or two. So, bam, Alix Vans. Let's get into the jackets. Okay, I love jackets. Jackets are my favorite thing. I like pants a lot too. T-shirts are easy, like I said, you can buy Gildan ones, but pants and jackets are hard to find that you love a ton. So, this one, I loved a ton. This is the Balenciaga women's jacket, denim jacket from Spring Summer 17. This one is super sick. The reason it is a women's is because right here there's this stitch. So what it's meant to be is you're meant to, the girls are meant to button these three buttons and then unbutton these two and wear it like over the shoulder. So it's supposed to drape over the shoulder. But it's so oversized and so cropped that when I tried it on, like it fit me perfectly. I just don't button it like that. I just leave it totally unbuttoned. And I kind of pop the collar up because if you actually fold it down, it actually, when you wear it, it like makes it look like it's supposed to be over the shoulder. So I just kind of like leave it up like that. It's got two front pockets right here, two chest pockets. It sits, you know, right at the waist. It's like meant to be, let me see if you guys can see. Yeah, it's meant to be like super short. super wide, super oversized, and it's really hard to find a denim jacket that's cut like this. So, Demna, you were doing some great things at Balenciaga. I'm a supporter. So here you guys go, Balenciaga denim jacket. So this is the Stone Island Experimental Mesh Patch, like elongated, you know, part exposed down. Two 3D pockets, hand pockets, meaning like they come out and are like an actual square. Little overflap that you can kind of tuck your neck in when it's nice and cold outside. You know, it's got a nice hood with these pullable drawstrings. It's seriously insane. Oh my God, it feels so good. So shout out Liam, he has a little consignment store here in Portland. Bought this off of him, and then he came in the other day and he was like, yo, you know that jacket you bought, like I found out that, like, I'm gonna butcher the name, but Itor Trope, he's like a super, I'm sorry, I butchered that, but he's like a super experimental, like designer that just does like super technical fabrics. He just did a collection with G-Star. His collections are insane, but I guess that he worked on this jacket with Stone Island, which is why that it has the mesh patch. So anything that has a mesh patch like this that is see-through, it means that he worked on it with them. So I bought it for $7, and Liam was telling me, he's like, yo, if you put that on Grailed, you could list it at 2.5 easy. So I'm not going to. I'm gonna wear the shit out of this. And it's gonna be my only go-to winter coat. So I'm stoked. I wish I could link you to find this, but I've never seen it before and neither had Liam, so I had to buy it. Like, I even got the Stone Island hanger. So I love this thing. Even Tyler like texted me about it. Tyler's like known for Stone Island. But man, fuck, I love this thing a ton. Okay, cool. Next up. Next up, we just have something light. We have the Gosha and Levi's collaboration from Spring Summer 17. This is that corduroy like trucker jacket denim. It's not really a denim jacket, but it's cut in the shape of Levi's denim jackets, but it is like a corduroy jacket. Yeah, it's pretty simple, man. It just has like Gosha's name right there in embroidery, and that is honestly it. And then it has Gosha and Levi's tag right there. I got a size medium. I wanted to wear this a little bit more fitted. Yeah, man, I got this at, you know, Macus, we carry it. And it was a reasonable price. It was like $195. Not bad at all. I just wear it with like a white t-shirt, black pants, and then like boots. Super, super easy. Nice little springtime piece, obviously. Can't really like layer underneath it too much because it is pretty tight on me, but this is a jacket that my girlfriend kind of ends up wearing whenever she needs a jacket, so I don't get to wear it too much. But yeah, man, I love it. I'll try to see if there's some like Grailed article, or Grailed links or anything, or eBay or anything, so you guys can check it out. But yeah, here you guys go. Super sick. Next up, this is one of my most worn jackets. I can't wait for it to start getting cold again so I can bust it out again. It might look like a standard Alpha Industries bomber, but this is actually the Alique's New Happiness bomber, as you guys can tell right there. Bam. This is from their Spring Summer 17 collection. It is super, super cozy. So this is actually enzyme washed and silicone washed and then dried too. So it doesn't feel like any, I mean, my brother even too. My brother got a standard Alpha Industries and he even tried to throw in the wash to make it feel like this, but it doesn't work because you need a certain chemical that like breaks down the fibers and makes this super soft. So that's what makes this jacket so special, is the treatment process on it. And it even was kind of shrunk a little bit. So now it's like a little bit more cropped than a standard Alpha Industries bomber, which is really, really rad. So I got an XL, I just wanted it super big so I could throw anything underneath it. I could throw a denim jacket, I could throw a hoodie. It's really nice. They also added their own Alique's drawstring right here with their own Alique's zipper to the little patch right there. We're gonna be getting a ton more of these types of like jackets in fall and spring 18. So we're gonna push Alique's heavy. Like I say, one of my favorite brands. So bam, here you guys go. Alique's New Happiness. All right, you guys, last up but definitely not least, we have this just vintage Carhartt jacket that has been stonewashed and enzyme washed. I got this from Cole's Vintage Collection at the shop. It is super, super sick. You know, it's hard to find a jacket. I mean, it's not hard, but I mean, nowadays it is. A jacket that's, you know, shorter and wider because that's all they did in the 90s. You know, like that's the stuff that they made. So it's really, really nice. The sleeves hit me like right here. You know, if I find a jacket that fits my body perfectly, it's pretty rare because I do have a, like, you know, I'm a little bit broader, but I'm short. So it's hard for me to find stuff that fits me perfectly. So when you find something that fits you perfectly, cop it. Two hand pockets, one chest pocket. And again, this particular one, like the bomber, was stone washed. So it was just beaten to shreds and then enzyme washed with a silicone. So it's super, super soft, which is hard. I mean, I even tried vintage shopping and found some Carhartt jackets and they're pretty stiff. So this is a special one. I'm stoked on it. Bam, here you guys go. So thank you guys again so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope I didn't ramble. I probably did ramble because, you know, I haven't talked about this stuff. I haven't made a video. I'm kind of, you know, out of shape when it comes to making videos. So I hope you guys still enjoyed it. You guys have been asking me a ton. And when I posted that tweet, I think it almost got 1,000 likes or something like that. So y'all wanted this, so I appreciate it. Thank you for still continuing to support me. You know, even though I did leave YouTube, it means a lot that you guys still fuck with it. I got some stuff coming out in the works soon. You know, I'm really excited about that. I got, you know, some clothes I'm working on. So real cut and sew stuff. So I won't mention too much. I would rather just get it done and then hype it. I don't want to be one of those people. So, man, yeah. Maybe I'll sprinkle, you know, a few videos every year for you guys, at least to let you know I'm still here and let you know about what's going on and you know, any updates or anything like that. This is my new apartment. I live in here with Josh, my brother. We are like 3 blocks from Macus. I love it. It's all like concrete. We don't pay too much more than we did in our other apartment. So it was a really, really good steal. So I really, really love where we're at. I hope to stay here for a while, but you know, who knows what's gonna happen. So thank you guys, man. Shit. Fuck yeah. I will try to link everything that I showed off in the description. If not, if it's sold out, I'm sorry. I'll try to find alternatives. But appreciate you guys sticking with me, man. How do I end the videos? Oh, yeah. Okay, I actually forgot. So thank you guys so much for watching. And remember to stay fresh, my friends. Fuck yeah. Okay, peace.